Welcome back, Tenfolders, and thank you very much for being with us. Thank you for watching Tenfold Live. Remember, this show is proudly brought to you by Liberty. A very, very special shout out goes out to Liberty for giving us the chance to share all this awesome knowledge with you. Someone is asking, how do I send questions? I can see you guys are trying to assist us. I've got a question that I want you guys to help me with. How do I do that? Well, remember, on our app, just go to your app store, look for the Tenfold Education app. On that app, just go to the options and look for the tutor option. You click on it. There's a nice little fellow waiting for you to give them questions. You'll either upload a video or you upload a photo, or you can even type the question out. We will receive it and help you to understand how to work with that. But on today's program, it is mathematics. We're up and running parallel to ourselves with revision of anything and everything that you guys might have on mathematics, anything that is troubling you, any concept, send it through to us. We'll help you to understand how do you work with those particular concepts. The next question is financial mathematics, my favorite topic, right? Very, very special to me. I don't want to lie to you, right? For various reasons, but we won't go to those reasons. So there's a question here, which is an awesome question on financial math. Let's go and check out what this is all about. We are being informed here that a business installs a server for 500,000 rands, right? Business installs a server for 500,000 rands. The value of the server depreciates at 20% per annum according to the diminishing balance method. And now we are required to do a couple of things here. So let's look at the questions. Number one, they want us to calculate the scrap value of the server at the end of 6 years. Beyond that, they want us to work out, they say the server is going to be replaced in 6 years. So they want us to figure out the cost of the new server if the inflation rate is 7% per annum. And then on the third question, I'm just moving, trying to check something here because it's a very important concept that is being discussed in this particular question, right? The third one says, on the day the server gets installed, the business sets up a sinking fund into which equal monthly installments must be paid. And interest on this fund is 8% per annum, compounded monthly. The first payment will be made immediately, and then there's a lot of very interesting things that are going on there that we're going to look at very shortly. Right. Now, let's talk about this, guys. This is what we call the sinking fund, the concept of the sinking fund, right? And for you to be able to ace any sinking fund question, you need to understand the story around what is going on with the sinking fund. What happens with the sinking fund is you've got, let's just say, I'm going to use papers here. You guys sent me questions, so I'll use them to try and make a demo for you guys to understand what I mean by that, right? Now, check here. I can see we are being asked at some point to figure out what the sinking fund is going to be or to work out something about the sinking fund, right? Now, for us to see, if we want to get there eventually, we need to have the following story in mind. There's a server. Your company needs a server, right? It could be anything for that matter. They're going to need a server, but there's two of them at the store. What happens is they're going to buy this one. They're buying this one. If you buy something and you use it, what happens to it? It's going to depreciate in value. It's going to become cheaper and cheaper and cheaper and cheaper. But the one that is new that you're going to need to buy later, what is happening to it? It's getting more and more and more and more and more expensive, right? So there's going to be a difference between the value of the old one and the value of the new one. That difference, the monetary difference between those two values, is what you call the sinking fund. And you will need to have that extra money in order to afford the new server after selling the old one. So if you've got that idea in mind, it becomes very simple for you to understand what is going on in this particular story. So let's see what we can do in trying to answer this question, right? We've got a server. This is a sinking fund question. It's a beautiful question, right? We've got a server. I don't know how your server looks, so what I'm going to do is I'll just put a nice, beautiful box here. I can't really draw a nicer server than the one that I have here, right? There's two of them, both of them at whatever store where they sell these servers, right? Okay, this one is server A. This is going to be server B. Now, server A is the one that you are buying. You buy this one, right? Because you are buying it, it's going to depreciate. This one is the one that depreciates. Why is it depreciating? It depreciates because you own it. You are using it. The question said it is depreciating on diminishing balance method. It's a reducing balance method. That means the depreciation formula we're going to need to use will be A equals to P into 1 minus I to the power of N. They could have said straight line depreciation, so please keep that in mind. Now, since the one that you're owning is becoming cheaper and cheaper because it's losing value, dropping from a price of 500,000 rands, right? Remember, this was 500,000. Both of them, when they are new, they are worth 500,000 rands, right? You're going to buy the first one. You're going to use it. It will depreciate in value. But the one that is left at the store is gaining value due to inflation, right? So this one is affected by inflation. Remember, inflation basically is the general increase of prices over time, right? It's the reason why the price of bread is 14 rands this year, but I promise you in 2030, the price of bread will not be 14 rands. It's going to be more expensive, and that is because of inflation. Now, you should know by now that if you are dealing with inflation and you want to figure out how much things will cost later, you use the compound growth formula to try and figure out anything around the concept of inflation, right? So this is basically what the whole story of the sinking fund looks like. The one on the left loses value. The one on the right is going to be affected by inflation, so it's going to get more and more expensive. Okay, now the idea is at the end, once you're done using the one on the left and you sell it, you want to use that money that you get from selling the old one, right? And you're going to obviously need extra money to afford the new one. That money that you're going to need is what we call the sinking fund, the money that you're short by. Okay, now the first question, right? The first question here is asking for something very exciting. This into us, calculate the scrap value of the server at the end of 6 years, right? If the depreciation rate is 20%. Okay, cool. So what do we know? Well, we know that this is a pain question, right? I always tell my learners, this is a pain question. Why do I call it a pain question? We're going to have to look for all those variables, and then only one of them is going to be unknown. So the principal value of this particular server was 500,000 rands. We don't know what the value is going to be later after it has depreciated. We know the rate of depreciation is 20% as a decimal. It is going to be 0.2, and this is going to last for 6 years, right? Then from here, you then go to substitute. Your A will just simply be 500,000 into 1 less 0.2 to the power of 6. And then you go and fetch your calculator, which is an instrument and not a monument. So you guys must use it. Okay, 500, 1, 2, 3, that's 500,000. You have 1 minus 0.2, and you need to raise this to the exponent of 6 years. And then you press the equality sign, you're getting 131,072 cents, okay? 131,072 cents. So this is the value of this particular server after it has depreciated. It drops from 500,000 to this 100,000 rands. That's a serious drop. Remember, things depreciate pretty fast, guys. They depreciate pretty fast, but the inflation is always, always slow. Okay, cool. Now, they said the scrap value, so that's the scrap value. Sometimes they don't say scrap value, so check for words such as the book value, right, of this particular thing. They might say the scrap value. They might say the value after depreciation, or maybe if it's in case of cars, they'll say maybe the trade-in value of that particular item. This is basically the value of the item after some time. Important. Okay, cool. The next question says, the server needs to be replaced after 6 years. Calculate the cost of the new server if the inflation rate is 7%. It's going to take us 6 years. We are increasing this with 7%. Keep that in mind. Right. Once more, inflation is a pain question, right? Inflation is a pain question. So I'm simply going to put this as my data. Now I'm looking for the values of what we know. We know the principal value, the original value of these servers is 500,000 rand. We don't know what the value is going to be later. The rate of depreciation is not 0.7. It's 7%, which is 0.07. You can write it as 7 over 100 in your calculator. Pretty obvious. It's nothing wrong with that. It's still okay. And then we know this is also lasting for 6 years. So let's try and figure out what is the value of this particular thing later on. So you got 500K into 1 plus, sorry for that, 0.07 to the power of 6. Oh, the math is exciting. Anyways, So now I'm going to go to my calculator and try to figure out what is that going to give us. I'm sitting with 500, 1, 2, 3, 500,000 rent. Is that 5 million or 500 backspace? I think I got too many zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, enough now. Okay. And then we are growing 1 plus 0.07, close bracket. This is also happening to the power of exactly 6. So it's growing for 6 years, right? Okay. And then if you push in on the equality sign, you then end up with a very awesome number, 750,365. Okay, 750,365 point. This is money. It's going to have to be 0.18. So it's going to be 0.18. Now, because I know I might need this number later, I'm going to store this number somewhere, right? You can decide to write it in full, right, as comma 1759. So if you ever need it, you're going to need to use this full number here, right? You're going to need to use the full number with all its decimals. I'm rounding off because I'm providing my final submission, but you might need to find yourself in a position where you need to obviously use that full number if you ever need it. So what are we sitting with here? We're sitting with the value of the server after depreciation and the value of the server after inflation. That's the cost of replacing the server. Now, let's go and look at the final question. We're not going to get a chance to do the last question, but I'm going to give you an idea of what's going on with 5.3. On the day the server gets installed, the business sets up a sinking fund into which they put equal monthly installments that must be paid. Interest on the fund is 8% per annum. So the fund is paying 8%. We're going to make multiple installments, monthly installments. Now, when you see these kinds of things, you know that we are now dealing with an annuity, right? We're now going to be dealing with an annuity. Because we are saving money, the annuity we are working with is definitely going to be the future value annuity. You don't work with annuities until you see someone making multiple payments or multiple deposits into some random account, right? Then the interest that we are being paid is 8%. And then the first payment will be made immediately. And the last payment will be made at the end of the six-year period. We want to calculate how much these people need to pay every month. Okay. Right. So what do we know? Well, we know the following. We're going to have a sinking fund here. We're going to have a sinking fund, which is the difference between AI minus AD. It tells you the difference, the extra amount you need if you're going to be trading in your old server, getting the money, and you need extra money in order to afford the new particular server that you are interested in, right? And you have to be careful if they're really asking for the sinking fund or they're just asking you for something else. They're saying, hey, this business set up a sinking fund to which they're going to do these multiple payments, right? So what I'm going to simply do here is I'm going to look for the difference between these two amounts. That's what we are saving for, right? 750,000 minus 131,000 is the amount of money that you want to save for. And that will be the future value. So we're going to use the future value formula. We've got the future value, we've got X, we've got I, and we've got N. The future value is 750.365. That number that we got here, we need to minus from that number, 131,072. That's what we are subtracting. You end up with 619,293. Okay, 619,293 point something. What is something? It's 0.18. So 0.18. We are looking for the monthly payments. The interest, they said 8% at 0.08 compounded monthly, right? And then it's going to last for 6 years. So 6 years every month, it has to be 6 times 12. But they said the payments are made immediately. So you're going to need to add an extra one, because if you're making an immediate payment, there's an extra one payment that you're going to definitely need to worry about. So the future value formula is F is X into 1 plus I to the power of N minus 1. Everything divided by 1, by I, we are looking for X. So cross multiply the I divided by the bracket. Your X is going to be F multiplied by I divided by 1 plus I to the power of N minus 1. Ah, I trust your calculator skills. It's just a matter of substituting that 619,293.18 times 0.08 compounded monthly over 1 plus 0.08 monthly to the power of 6 times 12, right? 6 times 12 plus 18. Very important for you to keep that in mind. 6 times 12 is 72. If you add 1, because they said immediately, you are sitting with exactly 73, right? And you guys will just simply finish it off by just typing this in your calculator. You're going to get an answer of how much these people need to pay on a monthly basis.